With more than 300 women and men, we started this current phase of indefinite hunger strike on May 1st, the International Workers' Day. The state government sent the medical team for 2 days and then abruptly stopped the whole thing. They were not willing to talk to us in any manner, and after almost 10 days, we could not sustain this large group of hunger strikers because we don't have enough toilets, medicine and medical help and other facilities. So we had to request most of the people to step down. And now some 100 women and few men are on hunger strike for the 12th day today. Even after 12 days of hunger strike, neither the central government nor the Tamil Nadu government has come forward to talk to us, even to come and help us with a medical team or any other sanitation help. If this is the way we deal with a non-violent struggle, what kind of message are we sending to the youth of this country? When a group of Maoists or Naxalites kidnap a collector or an MLA, our governments come forward to do anything, to set up a negotiating team, to send the team to the jungle, to grant all their wishes and demands. But when hundreds and thousands of people here have been striking for more than 9 months now, so non-violently and peacefully, the governments are ignoring us completely. This is not good for India's future, India's democracy, and the survival of ordinary citizens in this country.